Well, I guess for the Yankee rollover, this keyboard supports two-handed tech, yes, spam. Optical mechanical switches. These are the best you can get in gaming peripherals, whether it be a keyboard or a mouse. The Corsair have now introduced these switches into what they call their KPX linear switch on the brand new K100 RGB keyboard. Coupled with the 4000Hz polling, it makes for the fastest gaming keyboard I have tested to date, and in fact, even faster than any mouse I have also tested here at the studio in terms of input lag. Though exactly how much faster is it? Well, let's find out. The optical mechanical switch differs from a standard mechanical switch in that a micro beam is used to actuate the key press as opposed to the standard mechanical switch, which uses a traditional lever. This allows for even more consistency at a micro level when it comes to typing and actuating keys. Though testing out the input lag figures on this keyboard, it is simply the best numbers I have seen here in the studio of any device tested so far, scoring roughly 1 to 2 milliseconds on average lower than that of a Logitech mouse. It is quite an impressive feat, and again, this kind of gear is, although in the grand scheme of things, better for competitive play, it is not going to magically make you a better player per se. So I will preface this video by saying, if you suck at 5 milliseconds input delay, then you're still going to suck at 0.5 milliseconds delay. Though if you are winning games in high-ranked tournaments, then that 2 milliseconds could make a difference. And this is why I'm sure highly competitive gamers at a pro tier level will have keen eyes for gear like this. Firstly, part of this latency advantage is due to the 4000Hz polling rate, which is native to the K100 RGB. And this is a fourfold improvement over the previous models that carried 1000Hz polling. However, this difference alone will actually only account for a shift in roughly 0.375 milliseconds average over that of 1000Hz. 0.5 milliseconds average versus 0.125 milliseconds average. If you want to understand the math behind this, then I will leave more details in the description below. The rest of this extremely quick and sensitive key press lies in one more factor, the height of the actuation itself. This is an extremely high actuation point, where in the B-roll you can see that it is almost immediately actuated after a slight press. This is good for getting the fastest reactions for gaming. However, there is a trade-off in my opinion of more typos, which is where I experienced a lower words per minute score when typing as a consequence versus my traditional score, which is around 125 words per minute. However, since this is a linear switch, there is also no feedback, which having no resistance is preferred by most gamers. The keycaps are double shot PBT, so they will last a lot longer than cheaper ABS, and the sounds to the presses is very pleasant to the ears. I will let you take a quick listen. So the hardware is definitely there for gamers. However, the K100 RGB also features a lot more. The included wrist rest has a soft cushion feel with artwork and the Corsair logo printed over the top, and it is actually very comfortable for an included wrist rest, to the likes where it's easily the best wrist rest I've seen included with a keyboard to date. On the left hand side is 6 programmable macro keys, and you can use them for other functions if you wish, which you can then just above that at a heartbeat change to a different set of macros by simply pressing the profile button, which is the sign of a person. This will also change the lighting if you have set that to the different profile too. Within the iCue software, you can also program each individual key with multi-layer RGB effects and link that to other Corsair gear that has RGB and iCue enabled. As far as how many profiles you can have, I believe it is unlimited. Though to the right of that is a custom dial knob that can also be used for a variety of different functions with its own backlight to indicate which function it uses, whether it be changing tracks in Spotify or changing the brightness of the keyboard. Basically, you don't have to be gay to appreciate this knob. To the right of that is a Windows lock key function, then in the center is an LED visual display to inform you of things like wind lock, numb lock, and scroll lock, etc. Then the last but not least feature is the media keys, which having a mute and volume scroll is essential for me personally. Lastly, included in the box is 2 different sets of keycaps, which have different textures if you want to provide a different look over your wires keys. And there is a keycap puller if you wish to take off the keys and clean the keyboard itself. The board underneath has 1 layer of tilt adjustment, and the sides feature clear, which allow the LEDs to breathe through, which if you are wondering, yes, those lights too are individually backlit. Lastly, the base of the keyboard has a brushed aluminium finish, and a mix of hard plastics on the sides is used to reflect the RGB. And so with all that out of the way, it's now conclusion time. And who is the K100 RGB for? Well, if the price tag of $230 USD, or in Australia, $380 Aussie, doesn't deter you at first, then this is a premium keyboard that Corsair have quite simply nailed. I wouldn't ask for anything more from a keyboard personally. The layout, the materials used, the wrist rest, the noise and the feel of the switches, double shot PPT keycaps, amazing bling, coupled with the software, makes for a keyboard that has so much customization and expandability. Whether you are a competitive gamer playing for some serious cash, or you're a wannabe placebo pro that thinks that having a 5 millisecond advantage is going to make you a pro even though you suck, or you are a video editor needing to make limitless macros or remap keys, then this keyboard is definitely going to impress. Also, if you don't like the uber responsiveness of the keys as well, then I am told that there will be different mechanical flavors of this keyboard being introduced, which will have lower actuation points and may be better for people like me who are prone to making more typos on the linear high actuation switch like this one on the K100 RGB Optical. Anyhow, if you guys enjoyed today's video, then be sure to hit us up with the like button. And also, if you enjoy watching this content around Tech Yes City and you want to see at the moment it drops, be sure to hit that subscribe button, ring that bell, and I'll catch you in another tech video very soon. Peace out for now. Bye.